know it's a massive spoiler alert, but it's ending with the castle in the actual episode.
Yeah, well, people still don't know what it means.
Yeah, exactly. Have you kind of made sure that it's more acceptable to audiences, they actually understand what's going on, or are you going to keep it?
Well, our ending's going to be quite different.
Okay.
Yeah, we're on a different path. But I think, weirdly, we have more room than we had in the book to explore these things. And we're going to be able to, you know, if the show goes on, we'll be able to explore all kinds of things that we didn't get a chance to.
How much did you take the public's reaction to the pilot into account in going into production on the rest of the series?
I have always been dumb enough to read everything online. You know, when X-Files started, it was the beginning of this. You know, I remember the very first news groups, you know, I remember the screen, black and green, I'm old enough to remember all that. And I always read everything, and it's quite painful, as I'm sure you know. And I still do that. There's probably 13,000 comics now. I probably read all 13,000 comics. In this case, actually, it wasn't that helpful because most of them were so positive. But every once in a while you read something, a question somebody has, a point somebody has, and you go, that's interesting. I don't think you want to write for those people, but it's a tool. And I'm a big believer in using tools wherever I can find them to help tell a story.
When you read The Man in the High Castle for the first time, what was the reception like? Was it like a popular thing, or was it like people like...
Well, first of all, when I saw the cover, I was like immediately, like, what? You know, Nazis in America, what? And I think, look, I was a huge consumer of television and movies as a kid. And so I was very used to happy endings. And it really struck me that there's nothing inevitable about a happy ending. You can't assume the good guys are going to win. And actually, if you look at history, bad guys win an awful lot. You know, I do think, as our president likes to say, the long arc of history bends toward justice. I do think that's true. But in the short term, there's some really pretty terrible things that happened. And that just made me think. I think that's why the book stayed with me all those years. And it's very much part of what the TV series is about, is don't assume the good guys are going to win. And I would say, you know, that's kind of the thing the show says to modern audiences, is if you want to change the world, you better do it. Because it's not going to just happen on its own.